Welcome to our, I think it's our 24th Traveling Thursday, and we are excited and honored that you're traveling with us to Thailand tonight. So on the screen tonight, you see with me Angie and Alex and Steve. They are actually sitting in Thailand, in Phuket, and it's already the 25th Friday morning, 7 a.m. So we're honored that you guys got up early to go through this presentation with us.
Our pleasure.
I am going to just give you a little bit of an overview of what to expect today, a little bit of an introduction of our company, and a few things that I want to highlight. And then we will pass it over to the folks in Thailand, and they'll be talking about why you want to travel and dive in Thailand. We'll hear about the Phoenician and the giant, the two liveaboards, and details about the diving in Thailand, where and what you're going to see, and what else there is to do in Thailand. And then we will have some like a Q&A session at the end. And we will let you know where we're traveling in 2 weeks. About Fly and Sea Dive Adventures. This is our crew here, five of us. And then some of you already know that we have a new part-time person. You'll not hear from her, but Donna is helping us with a lot of administrative pieces. We have been in business since 1997, and yes, that means we are celebrating our 25th anniversary this year. Proud to have weathered many storms, from 9/11 to SARS to the downturn in 2008, and we like to think we have come through the pandemic. Let's hope that is true, that we have passed this. So there's over 70 years of combined diving and travel experience between in our team. We represent over 40 destinations in the world, pretty much every good dive destination you can book with us, over 100 liveaboards and resorts and dive operators, all the reputable companies that we want to rely on for giving us fabulous dive experiences. We work with, including the folks here at Master Liveaboards. We are IATA appointed. That means that we are able to issue our own tickets and are in control of what we book and how we book it, and don't necessarily need to be on the phone with the airline for hours on end. There are exceptions to the rule, so we're used to being on hold with people throughout the day. You already know that you can book into the groups that we run with dive shops all over North America that we work with in Canada and the US when they put on their group trips, and that can be anywhere in the world. If you don't like to travel with groups, or you want to go somewhere where there is no group trip, or you have a specific time that you do want to be away, we also do individual trips where you want, how long you want to go, with whom you want to go. We set that up as well. So those are custom trips that we arrange also. Having said that, we are super busy right now, and those of you who are currently having a file with us and are traveling in the next little while, you have been super patient, and yes, we're hiring. If you know of someone in the Greater Vancouver area who is a travel consultant and may be interested in getting involved with dive travel, would you pass this on to them? The job is on the website GoToHR, and it would be fabulous if we would probably not in 2 weeks, but in the near future, have another person on the on our team with us. So we would love to hear from you or someone that you know that you've passed this on. And because of our 25th anniversary, you know that we are running monthly challenges. So the current challenge, which is pretty much come to an end today, is that we had asked you, name at least two reasons why you love to travel. And the draw among all of those who have entered either on Facebook or Instagram or to our email address contest@flyandsee.com, we will draw for a $100 gift card tomorrow. So watch Facebook tomorrow. We will announce the winner there tomorrow. To give you a bit of a taste, some of the top reasons why people are traveling: they want to meet new people. They obviously, travel and diving is intricately connected, and exploring the underwater world. People are saying they want to experience new cultures, seeing other parts of the world. Underwater photography is an important reason to dive in warmer waters. So there'll be more, and this will actually be on our blog, probably sometime on the weekend. Your top 25 reasons why you love to travel. And just a hint, the new challenge for the month of April has to do with underwater life. So be prepared to enter another contest. The draw tomorrow on Facebook. The top 25 dive destinations was our previous challenge, and Thailand was number 18 in our top dive destination list. Some of you have read the blog, and you may know that Indonesia by far was number one, and that's where Master Liveaboard operates as well, just as an FYI. So without further ado, I am going to hand it over to Alex and Steve and Angie.
So, Sawadee Kap, as we say in Thailand. It's a real pleasure to be here today. This is probably one of my favorite presentations that we do for various people around the world. Thailand has been my home for the last 5 years. I'm married to an incredible Thai lady, so it's a real pleasure that we can present this incredible country to you. We've got Steve, who is the owner of the two boats that we have in Thailand.
Good morning.
He is from Holland, and Steve has lived in Thailand for years.
23.
So almost as old as I am. And then we have Angie, who works a little bit on the kind of office reservations, but also at the moment mainly on board, wining and dining our guests, looking after them in the water. So is the true expert of the liveaboards that we have here in Thailand. So I am going to pass everything over to Angie, and I will be doing the clicking in the background.
Thank you, Alex, and Sawadee Kap to everybody over in Vancouver, and good evening. Thank you for joining us. Just a little bit about me. I am South African, but have also been living here in Thailand on and off for many, many years now, and have been fortunate enough to work with the junk liveaboards. I've never been so passionate about a job in my life. I find these boats exquisite. The crew's amazing, and I'd like to share a little bit about this with you. If I start by why would you visit Thailand? Basically, our climate here is absolutely incredible. It's always warm. We do have a rainy season and a non-rainy season, but to be very fair, the temperature doesn't change between the seasons. We still have a lot of sunshine, and this makes for absolutely incredible warm water diving. I personally never dive with a wetsuit. It's beautiful, the marine life. The coral is just so diverse and fantastic. We have whale shark encounters, manta encounters, turtles. The big pelagics are here, not as much as they were maybe 20 years ago, but we do encounter them. And the smaller life is extremely diverse underwater. Above the water, Thailand has the most amazing temples, there's elephant sanctuaries, there's just an absolutely beautiful life here to be experienced, both on the boats, below the water, and on land. The islands are magnificent, the food is incredible, and for those of you who don't like too spicy food, the Thais have become accustomed to the Europeans' palate, and yes, the food is exactly what you need. Then if we go on to travel information. So Thailand is a really easy place to travel, especially for people, individuals on your own. no problem at all. They have been accustomed to travelers for many, many years. Most Thai speak English, certainly enough to get by with somebody who doesn't speak any Thai. The currency is the Thai baht. Most Westerners can get into Thailand simply on a 30-day visa on arrival. So it's really easy. Rainy season is pretty much between May and October. But when we say rainy season, as you know, because of climate change, it kind of varies. You have thunderstorms, but then you have sunny skies for the rest of the day as well. November to February is pretty much your driest season. So then we literally have no rain at all. And then the hottest periods of the year are pretty much March and April. All buildings are air conditioned, so we don't generally feel the heat. So now travel information for current entry requirements into Thailand. There is no mandatory quarantine anymore required in Thailand. You literally arrive as a fully vaccinated individual, and you have to have health insurance of at least $20,000, which covers COVID, and obviously your return flight ticket. With this on arrival, you will be tested at the airport and you will be requested to go to your hotel and remain at your hotel until you get the result of this test. The result usually takes between 6 and 12 hours. For those of you arriving in the afternoon, you probably only want to relax in the hotel anyway. And then on day 5 after arrival, you are given at the airport a self-test. So you will self-test yourself and check after 5 days. But that's basically it. So nice and easy. Come and see us here in Thailand.
Just one thing to add there, Angie. You know, this is, I've been out quite a few times, various dive shows since COVID began, and actually it's getting easier and easier to get into Thailand. They do still have something called the Thailand Pass, which is a little bit of a typical Thailand bureaucracy. Stick with it. It's not too bad to fill the online forms out. Like Angie said, it's well worth it. And the testing and the whole process at the airport is really quick. I've actually gotten from the plane through immigration, through testing, into a taxi quicker than I have done at London Heathrow. So that's how efficient things really are here at the moment in Thailand.
So now to get to my biggest passion, our boats. We have two boats, the Junk and the Panisi. So to give you a little bit of background on the Junk, this vessel is wooden. It is completely made of Asian teak. Absolutely magnificent. There's not too many liveaboards out there nowadays which are completely old wooden boats. The Junk also has these magnificent sails, 330 square meters of them. Once those sails go up, which I will tell you is fun and a lot of work, but that boat is just beautiful. It really does take you back in time. The history of the boat, it has an incredible history as well. It started out as a cargo vessel, then completely remodeled and fitted in 1997 to be a liveaboard. She is a real traveling piece of history. She's been in a couple of movies. One of the James Bond movies, a part of it was filmed aboard Cabin One, if I'm not mistaken. You will see James Bond in that cabin. but basically, we have 6 cabins aboard. She accommodates 18 divers very comfortably. There are 2 double cabins at the very front, then followed by 2 triple cabins and 2 quad cabins. Each cabin has its own ensuite bathroom. And they all have hot water showers. The rooms also have aircon as well as fans. The outside, there's plenty of space outside on the front deck, which is also doubles as the dive deck. Eating areas inside and outside. The inside area we use for dive presentations. And then she has a top deck, which you can sit out in the sun. Part of it is covered, some is not covered. So lounges, bean bags, she is an absolute adventure, absolutely beautiful. And one of the things I have to point out is that the crew on board, they've been with her for a very long time. They work like clockwork. They love the guests. They love to interact with the guests. So your adventure is not just pure diving, but it really is a whole all-rounded adventure. Then on to the Panisi. The Panisi is not quite as old as the junk. She is an Indonesian-styled Panisi, and her registered name is Cengi Sao. If you do a little bit of history on Cengi Sao, you'll find out that she was one of the most fearless pirates, female pirates of Southeast Asia. So we like to think of her as our pirate boat. Nobody going to be made to walk the plank on her, though, I promise. She sails within Thailand and Myanmar. Obviously, the situation at the moment, we are not traveling to Myanmar, but hopefully in the future again. The Panisi also accommodating 18 divers. She has 7 cabins. The very front cabin is we call it the honeymoon suite. It's a double cabin, very spacious, followed by twin cabins, double cabins, which can also be made into twins, and then quad cabins at the back. So accommodating the same as the junk. She's slightly more spacious. Obviously, she was not a cargo vessel. She was always designed to be a liveaboard. Also, wooden everywhere, absolutely beautiful. When she rocks and lulls you to sleep at night, you hear the wood gently creaking. It's just, for me, she's just beautiful. When the sails go up, the same, you can see on the pictures, it's quite a job to get those sails up, but the crew love it, and they absolutely love to see the passengers' faces when they see our beautiful Panisi in all her glory. Lots of outdoor space again, beanbags, sun deck. The dive deck is nicely proportioned for divers. Everybody gets to spread out a little bit. Another thing I must mention about both our boats is that the only complaint you have about the food is that you put on weight. Our chefs are incredible. I have to try really hard whenever I'm on board not to eat too much, because they simply come out with the most spectacular meals. And yes, they do accommodate for our palate, so the food is definitely not too spicy, but the spice is always there for you to add. Being Thai food, obviously some people like it spicy. It's a nice combination, a small portion of Western food with each dinner meal, but the rest is basically Thai. They like to experiment and give us all sorts of Thai dishes we don't traditionally try. And yes, food is incredible. The crew aboard the Panisi as well, they are a unique team. Both of our boats take you from having a simple diving trip to having an absolute adventure. These are times you will never forget, these trips on board either the junk or the Panisi. So now let's go underwater for a little bit. Basically, our minimum requirement to come on board the boat is that you have that you are an open water diver. We are happy to do adventure divers or advanced diver courses on board. All of our dive guides are also instructors. We're very selective with our dive guides. There can sometimes be a little strong current, but this is why we have really good dive guides to help you through it. They will make sure that you only dive what you're capable of diving and that you enjoy every dive. We do not require reef hooks at any point on our dives, but we will require an SMB. We do have them available on the boats as well. We do offer night dives as well as sunset dives on every trip, depending on the passengers. And if you prefer to do a night dive or a sunset dive, we offer a range of both. The water temperature, really warm. Basically, you need a shorty wetsuit or a pair of shorts. I always dive in shorts and a t-shirt. Some people obviously prefer to have some form of a wetsuit, but either a 1 mil skin or a 3 mil shorty, more than sufficient. The visibility, well, what can I say? It's forever. Obviously, occasionally you will have a little bit of an upwelling and some green water. There's nothing most of us can do about that. But the good thing about that is that it brings in the pelagics, because obviously it's food in the water. Other than that, honestly, if you look at our websites or our Facebook page, it's, you can see forever. The visibility is magnificent. Our trips, we do North Andaman as well as South Andaman. The boats kind of split the trips up between the best of Thailand is on board the Panisi, and she does 4 nights going south combined with 6 nights going north to the Similans. So it's a little bit of a one night, overnight long journey, but that's the best of Thailand. It's 10 nights. You get to do both. Alternatively, you can do either a 4 night or a 6 night of just Similan and Surin Islands on board the junk. And then, as I mentioned, there's the south as well. So the Panisi will do just the south. You can do a 4 night or combine it with a 6 night. We try to make sure that everything is available to everybody, whether you prefer a longer or a shorter trip.
And just to add here, guys, you can see on the map, we have Phuket International Airport. This is probably the best airport for you guys heading into Thailand, especially if you're doing a liveaboard. Most of the major Middle Eastern airlines will fly into Phuket. But of course, you can fly into Bangkok as well, the capital city of Thailand. And there's really cheap domestic flights for less than $50 just to get down from Bangkok to Phuket.
As Alex mentioned, you would fly to Phuket, but not far from Phuket is Phi Phi Island. This is one of our major dive areas on the southern trip. Phi Phi Island is absolutely breathtaking, as you can see from the photos. A real little gem out in the middle of nowhere. Beautiful beaches. The island is surrounded by these limestone cliffs. A lot of our diving is against the walls of these cliffs. There are some caves, there are some swim throughs. And when I say a cave, I'm talking something you can park a double-decker bus in. They're really beautiful. It's very dramatic and, yes, definitely not to be missed. We then move further south on the southern trip. Down to 2 dive sites, Hing Deng and Hing Wong. These translated are Purple Rock and Red Rock, some of probably 2 of the most spectacular pinnacles in the south. They are covered with soft corals, very colorful. Being open ocean dive sites, they reach down to over 70 meters. But these are where we find the pelagics, the whale sharks, the mantas, if there is a chance. These are pretty much the dive sites where we would spot them. These dive sites are quite distant, but not to be missed. They are really spectacular. Even if you don't see any big pelagics, they're still well worth the dives. And then if we move north, to give you a little information on Koh Barn, also one of the most beautiful dive sites in the north. Again, slightly different topography, changing from the limestone cliffs. Probably one of our best dive sites. Koh Barn, the one side has a gentle reef. The west ridge is more of a drift dive, but if there's no current, it can also be a really beautiful slow dive again. A good place to find rays, mantas, and whale sharks. Probably one of the most regular that we see these creatures. And the corals, again, here are absolutely spectacular. I've actually had a gentleman who has told me he'd like to put a bench down on the reef and just sit there for 40 minutes. Okay, something else within the Similan Islands, Donald Duck Bay, also a very popular dive site, generally nice and calm to dive at night. But this is a beautiful beach, part of the Similan National Park. And what we try to do is between dive 3 and dive 4, we try to take you on shore, obviously weather permitting, time permitting. We will stop just off of the island and everybody will be taken by dinghy on shore. There is a beautiful viewpoint where you can get some absolutely incredible photos. What can I say? The water's beautiful, warm. It really is paradise. Okay, now, if we look at the Similan Islands as a whole, there are 9, which is what Similan's stands for, basically 9 islands. Some of the dive sites here, Boulder City, Shark Fin Reef. These are boulder dive sites. Again, a change in topography from the limestone cliffs. These are massive boulders underwater. Really spectacular, some beautiful swim-throughs. Elephant Head Rock. The visibility on these dive sites is most of the time absolutely spectacular. You can see forever. Lots of small fish, occasionally some sharks, leopard sharks, black tip, white tip reef sharks. A lot of fish life, absolutely abundance of fish life here. A lot of small macro photography available here too. There are a few sites in the Similans where the coral has taken a little bit of a knock over the years, and there's some rubble. But I'll be honest, the octopus, the small life within the rubble, there's always something to find. You'll feel that your dives are never long enough. Here you can see some of the beautiful photos.
This is the last trip, wasn't it, we had?
Yes, this was taken by one of our photographers on the last trip. So gives you a good picture of the visibility as well as the ocean life.
And even sharks as well.
Very diverse. Then reaching further north from Similans, we reach the Surin Islands. This is probably the highlight of your Similan and Surin trip. I would say definitely the highlight, Rishu Rock. We try to do 3, sometimes even 4 dives on this dive site. It is a limestone pinnacle named after Cardinal Richelieu. There's a history behind Cardinal Richelieu and the Thai government and military. But this dive site is absolutely incredible. It is definitely the highlight of the north. It is a horseshoe-shaped dive site. So it doesn't really matter if there's a little bit of current, there's always somewhere to hide. And as I mentioned, we would do at least 3 dives on this dive site. There is so much to see. Within the rock face, you would start, you could do a deeper dive, make your way up using multi-level. There are eels everywhere. Every sort of crab, ghost pipefish, morays, frogfish, ornate ghost pipefish. We even have a resident tiger-tailed seahorse. And the fish life is incredible. My view on this dive site, it's like diving in a National Geographic's movie. It really is absolutely spectacular. Also a good place to see mantas and whale sharks.
I would agree. This is definitely for me, the top dive site in Thailand. This is where you're transported to another world. And actually every dive we do here is so different. You know, the morning dive to the lunch dive to the dusk dive, watching, you know, all the GTs hunting, the great barracudas coming in for their afternoon clean. It's just world class at Richelieu Rock. And don't forget these little harlequin shrimps, which are my favorite things, just walking up to starfish, chopping off a leg, dragging it home, and then eating it over the next week. Is there 2 pairs or 1 pair? I can't remember. Richelieu, it's definitely 1 pair. 2 pairs. There we go.
What is included? We would arrange transfers from the local airport or your hotel to the Panisi or the Junk. For pickup, embarkation as well as disembarkation. This is arranged only on the day of travel. So if you arrived at the airport on that day, unfortunately, this is not possible for international travelers at the moment, but we're hoping, as Alex mentioned, that things will change. But we will pick you up at your hotel. Onboard accommodation is based on double occupancy. If it's single occupancy, it's pretty much 80% surcharge. Full board includes 5 meals a day, snacks, soft drinks, juice, water. We have the most incredible coffee machines on board. I think that's actually the highlight of the boat at 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock in the morning. Everybody's lining up at the coffee machine. We also have a range of different teas available. We provide a deck towel for you as well as a bath towel for the bedroom. All bed linen, soaps and shampoos in the bathrooms. Your linen on the longer trips will be changed halfway through. We do up to 4 dives a day. Obviously, weather and where we're heading will depend on that. But generally, it's 3 dives and 1 either night dive or sunset dive every day. You will have an 11-liter aluminium cylinder with air fills. That's also included. Weight belts, land excursions. We do the stop in Donald Duck Bay on the islands in Similans, as well as we try to make a stop occasionally in Surin Islands at the Mokin village. These are nomadic people, and they have become resident now on one of the Surin Islands, and we try to take you there for a short educational visit. Nitrox is available. Yes, Nitrox is available on board. We also have the use of a kayak, so a little bit of snorkeling or kayaking is also possible. This is only possible in certain places because we also dive the national parks, and some of the national parks don't permit the kayaks, but if we're somewhere you can, by all means. What else to do in Thailand? Well, the list is never ending. This is an absolutely beautiful country, and I think the pictures speak for themselves. The reason Steve's been here 23 years, Alex has made this his home, and I'm pretty much got myself stuck here, tells you something about this beautiful place. There are magnificent temples, beautiful elephant sanctuaries, amazing beaches. The food is out of this world. There is so much adventure and different sorts of travel and trips. And it's really easy to travel in Thailand. As I mentioned earlier, Thailand has been accepting visitors by the millions for so many years. They are well set up for easy travel, convenient travel, and most of the Thais in Thailand speak English.
If you're doing a 10-night trip, you may not have the holiday to extend, but particularly our 6- and 4-night itineraries, you know, the guys at Fly and Sea will be more than happy to work with us to put some land excursions together. We work with a lot of properties here in Phuket, Bangkok, Chiang Mai, Chiang Rai, so all over Thailand to really help put that package together for you guys. But yeah, absolutely. Just look at some of those temples, and the food, of course, is my guilty pleasure. as you can probably see, but
our special offer for attendees, for those attending, thank you for joining us, and as on screen, you will receive free Nitrox for any trip on the Junk or Panisi if you book through Fly and Sea Dive Adventures within the next 30 days.
Great. Thank you so much, Angie. Yeah, that's a nice little offer that we thought we'd give you guys. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us to share a little bit of our slice of paradise early morning here, but not too late for you guys. We do have quite a nice video, but I am going to hand that over to Petra, who will share that.
Thank you, Alex. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you, Angie.
Let's look at the video, and then we'll get into the Q&A.
To the wild heart of life, the ground beneath my feet makes me feel alive. Well, I'm new to town and I don't know where I'm gonna stay, but I have purpose and I've come a long way now. I move amongst the selfless, I move amongst the free, I move along with purpose and I move along with ease. There's a place you feel alone. where the jungle meets the peaks, the wilted mountains that touch the sea. The people that I meet, each of a story, weather's on the rise. We move amongst the mountains, we move amongst the trees, we move along one surface, won't you move along with me?
Me want to go diving.
I need to get a trip out before the end of the season. That's
right. Yeah. Before we get into the Q&A, I just wanted to share, when you go on our website, you can actually check availability for both the Finisi and the Junk. So if you go to our homepage, flyandsea.com, and you go to Liveaboards, and then you scroll down past the globe, here we go. So you can either check for all the destinations in the world if you're specific for 1 week, but if you narrow it down to Thailand and you say you're looking for something between March and May is the default here, and whether you want a single space or if you need two spaces, you just change this and then you go and search trips, and here we go. So you can see there's space on the Junk starting tomorrow. And then there's Finisi space, Southern Thailand, Similan and Surins. And you can actually, I think there's availability, you can check all the way to almost 2025 or 24, something like that. So this is a good way to have a quick idea on both the cost as well as availability. And then you can actually click booking request that comes to us, and then we take it from there. So just as an idea, if you are looking for ideas of what to do and when. So let's get to the Q&A. And I know some of you have already put some things in the chat, so I'll start reading that out. Everyone has learned to ask if a night watch by a dedicated employee is maintained on vessels to lessen the risk of fire. Can you comment on that?
Yes, certainly. So with both of our boats, we don't have a dedicated individual on board, but both our captains are regularly, you will find them regularly through the night patrolling the boat. And many of our crew actually spend the night sleeping on board. So you will find one crew member on the dive deck, one crew member at the back of the boat, just through the night. They take turns, just making sure that somebody is up and available and checking the boat on both boats.
Great.
And just to add there, you might see the pictures on Facebook, but Steve might tell me the duration. We actually have full-blown fire equipment. You know, the crew will do training. They get on the full suits, the helmets, the breathing apparatus, and we'll run the hoses from bow to stern and practice the drills. So
we do fire drills every 2 weeks.
There we go. Every 2 weeks, the fire drills take place. Yeah. So, yeah, lessons can be learned from previous incidents. And, yeah, absolutely, the safety for fire is up there for us.
Joseph is asking if we're able to put together single divers to fill a room. And, yeah, Angie was referring to if you want your guaranteed own room, there's a single surcharge. But if you're fine with sharing the room with someone and you're a single traveler, absolutely. Now, we cannot guarantee that person doesn't snore. So I know you said LOL. Craig is asking if side mount is permitted.
Yes, most definitely.
Well, it's not easy. We've already answered the question of nitrox. Nate is asking if you can get a pony bottle on board.
We don't have pony bottles available currently, but if there's a specific request, we will do our best to accommodate.
Okay. And then I think both Bruce and Anthony are asking where the nearest chamber is.
The nearest chamber, as far as I'm aware, is in Phuket at Bangkok International Hospital. There is a chamber.
We actually have two chambers here on the island as well. The one in the Bangkok Phuket Hospital is actually run by expat divers. So a very professional setup there. Yeah.
And also just to add that there is speedboats available to evacuate from Similan Islands, from Surin Islands. The national parks have speedboats, and there is a medical center on the Surin Islands where we can take a patient for immediate care, and then they are evacuated by speedboat to the mainland.
Perfect. Andrew is asking, what time of year is the best for diving?
When you're free and we have availability, that's when's the best time.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but aren't most sailings between November and May?
Yes, there is, I would say between November and May is probably your clearest visibility, your least chance of rain. Obviously, there's no way of us accounting for that. But certainly between May and October, it is what we call the green season. So slightly more rainy, more windy.
Summer months as well.
Yeah, Steve was just adding there. If you can't come in November through to May, we do actually run short two-night trips. We call them, Southern Discovery Explorer trips, where we head off to PP, do the diving around there. It's relatively sheltered. Koh Lipe as well, which is great. We do some excursions there, dinner on the land, bar drinks as well. But that's a great kind of addition to maybe a 7-night shore-based trip in Phuket, tag on 2 nights on the Liveaboard. So we do still run throughout the year.
And I do want to add, because we do obviously get inquiries diving in Thailand from people who've never been. And while you can do shore-based or land-based diving, the best diving is out in the areas where it's really long boat ride if you just want to do this on a day trip. So Liveaboard is your best option. And Thailand is one of the few destinations where there's actually Liveaboards available that are shorter than a week. So for people that have never been on a Liveaboard and just kind of want to try out if this is for you, Thailand is a perfect destination to try that out.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Patricia is asking if there are smoke detectors in the rooms and the hallways.
Yes, there are smoke detectors. There's one in every room. There's two in each hallway. And they are within the saloons on the boats as well.
And then, is alcohol available on board?
Most certainly. We have beer and wine available on board. But if a customer would like to bring their own bottle of whiskey, we have no problem with that at all.
And after diving, obviously.
Yes, only after diving. If we see you with alcohol, no more diving for that day.
Yeah. Steve is asking, do you have larger than 80 cubic foot tanks? cubic foot.
Okay, Alex, is that a 15 litre?
Yes, we do have the largest. So we're converting it to English. Yes, we do have larger tanks available for those who need them as well. We don't do technical diving on day-to-day trips, but we even had a guest who had a twin set. We managed to set that up on the last trip. So, we can cater for all the weird and wonderful ways people choose to dive.
Perfect. So Nate's basically just making a statement here. February, March would be ideal for a time of year. I would say,
it's a good time at the moment. Yeah.
So basically, when it's rainy and cold and miserable here in the North American hemisphere, Thailand is the perfect place to be. Absolutely.
Yes, come to Thailand.
Are the trips non-smoking? Kent is asking.
No, you're welcome to smoke on board. We have dedicated smoking areas. So for the smokers, there would be a specific area where you can smoke, but no problem.
Can we do any dawn dives?
Basically, your first morning dive is pretty close to dawn. So we don't do sort of pre-sunrise dives, but your first dive is generally close to dawn.
Pretty much the first dive before the main breakfast, right?
Yes. So you have little breakfast first, which is available before the first dive, and then we have big breakfast available after the first dive.
Right. So really the motto of most liveaboards is eat, sleep, dive, repeat. Eat, sleep, dive, repeat.
Exactly.
Karen is asking if you have to follow the dive master on the dives.
We would prefer. Obviously, our dive masters know the dive sites. If they're experienced divers, obviously we can look at their qualifications and situation. But because we do encounter some current, we would prefer them to follow the dive sites.
Is solo diving allowed? Is Brian?
No.
We'll leave it there. And I do want to remind everybody, for those maybe who have not been on every presentation, because of our 25th anniversary, every booking that you make with us this year for a dive vacation is an entry into our 9-night Magic Resorts dive vacation in the Philippines for two people. That draw is happening in December of this year. So every new booking qualifies for this. So get your bookings in. In 2 weeks, we will be traveling to Grenada with Aquanauts Grenada. And any questions and comments, you know how to reach us here. diving@flyandsea.com. These webinars are being recorded, and so sometime next week you can find the recorded and edited version on our YouTube channel, as well as on our website. You can find those under the travel tools. We do appreciate reviews of both these webinars as well as our services. So Google reviews, Facebook reviews, we would love that. For now, I'm saying good night, goodbye, good morning, have a great day. Alex and Steve and Angie, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having us here.
Kapunka.
Thank you. I don't know what you're saying, but
and we'll give you a personal tour when you guys get here as well. We'll show you the best restaurants, and if you'd like a beer, we know the best bars as well. Look forward to seeing as many of the 70 people who are in here in Thailand at some point in the not too distant future. Thank you, Petra. It's been a pleasure as always.
Thank you, Petra, for your time.
Thank you for joining us tonight. And I hope we'll see everyone again in 2 weeks. Have a good night, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.